There's nothing the Apple fan community loves more than a juicy rumor, and that has certainly been the case for iPad 2. I feel like the rumor mill has been buzzing about the iPad 2 a couple of months before it was even announced, but today is the day. It is finally here. Hi, I'm MJ with iFixit, and we sent our intrepid Teardown team to the East Coast to get their hands on the iPad 2 a couple of time zones ahead of us here in California. So while I'm waiting to get my hands on mine, here's what they found. Let's start with the exteriors. The iPad 2 is 33% thinner than its predecessor, a bit lighter, and we hear that the tapered edges make it a little more comfortable to hold. Something you won't notice by holding it is that the iPad 2 also got a new model number. It's A1395. Because of how the edges are tapered, Apple had to switch from using clips to secure the display assembly on to using adhesive, meaning that if you ever need to replace your display assembly, you're going to need a heat gun and a lot of careful prying just to get it off. Once the display assembly was removed, we noticed that the iPad 2's battery was just a tiny bit better than its older brothers. The iPad 2's battery is a 25 watt hour unit compared to the original iPad's 24.8 watt hour battery. With such a small difference, it's safe to say that any improvement in battery performance can be attributed to software and other hardware changes. After disconnecting a few ribbon cables, our teardown surgeon was able to remove the logic board with ease. As expected, Apple used its A5 processor, but what we didn't know until recently is that this iteration is a 1 GHz dual-core processor with 512 MB of RAM. This is the first time Apple's used a dual-core processor in an iOS device. Another thing that's interesting is that the processor in our iPad 2 has manufacture dates of late January to mid-February 2011, making it appear that they're ramping up production right through the very last minute. As far as the front and rear-facing cameras are concerned, there aren't any big surprises. The FaceTime camera is VGA, and while the rear-facing camera can shoot 720p video, it captures stills at less than 1 megapixel. I'm a little disappointed that my digital camera from 1996 can shoot better stills than the iPad 2. But then again, I'm not sure that I'm really going to use the iPad 2 to capture candid images. One thing that is a little surprising is how teeny tiny the speakers are. They're so small, it almost looks as if they're an afterthought. So I guess you won't see me carrying my iPad 2 around on my shoulder, boombox style, anytime soon. So those are the primary changes with the iPad 2. One possible word of warning we have for you is that the LCD and glass on the iPad 2 are considerably thinner than on the iPad 1. And while this does make the device a little bit lighter, it's also going to affect its durability. And because the iPad is just one giant touchscreen, I don't really know that it's worth the trade-off. Here at iFixit, we give everything we tear down a repairability score between 1 and 10, 10 being the most repairable and 1 being the least. We've given the iPad 2 a repairability score of 4 out of 10. Heat gunning the display assembly is a total pain and makes it very likely that you'll break the glass during removal. The LCD is adhered to the front panel with foam sticky tape, increasing the chances of it shattering during disassembly. And the battery is buried all the way beneath the logic board and is glued to the rear case very securely. One positive note that we have is that Apple only used standard Phillips screws. No pentalobular or tri-wing funny business here, and for that, we thank them. For high-resolution photos and all the details, check out the full teardown on our site. For all the latest teardowns and repair videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Twitter at twitter.com/iFixit. Thanks for watching, and happy repairing!